Back to GeoGuessr. Sinvicta, hello.
Hello, Northern Lion. How you doing today?
It worked that time.
It worked. Third time's a charm.
Good luck, have fun.
Good luck, have fun. Episode 30, I believe. The field.
I believe you're correct.
It's probably not going to make up any ground this session.
I'm eager to play because my internet works.
Yep.
Like, oh my god, it's another world.
I thought you guys had a gigabit connection over there. How are you still running into internet problems?
I actually don't know. And this is something that I think might be... We have great internet, but we run into problems when when anyone's uploading, the download goes to garbage.
That's very weird.
I don't understand why. At all.
Domain. So,
and that's essentially that.
It's a mystery that someday will be solved, hopefully. Or maybe not.
I don't know if it's just like there's a throughput issue or something or what. But yeah, like whenever we're uploading, the download becomes garbage. I don't know if it's because like maybe like a website like this, it sends a ping to you that you have to send back. That's like, hey, I've sent you something. Let me know when you got it.
This is strange though, because upload is usually not affected by the download at all, or vice versa. I mean,
yeah, I mean that's
unless you're on like a 56K modem, but
no, I don't know. I don't know enough about the actual, you know, ins and outs of telecommunications to say what's going on.
Networking was never my strongest thing when I did IT.
We essentially got like a fat download pipe. For sure. The upload's okay, but the download is like, you could be downloading a terabyte of stuff and it's not going to affect anybody else's connection.
Here's what Rob would say. I got your fat download pipe right here.
I do like saying the expression fat pipe.
Which would be a great rapper name, by the way.
That would be a great name. It's probably been done.
Yeah. So, I'm getting mixed signals here.
Okay.
Everything is screaming. I mean, obviously France, but I have a feeling this is one of those French guesses that wants me to think France, but is actually in Canada.
What makes you think it's one or the other right now?
Well, the weather, not the weather, the surroundings to me indicates like way further north than France would be.
Mm.
I mean, France gets cold, don't get me wrong. But this
I
looks
think,
more
I think
Canadian.
You're fair to say it doesn't get that cold.
France?
Yeah.
Oh, that's what I'm saying. Like, it doesn't look like it gets this cold. This is like, if you just showed me a screenshot said where this is, I'd say, oh, it's probably like far northern United States or Canada.
Mm-hmm. So what makes you think it's France?
Just all the French that we've seen, but
okay, yeah.
I'm leaning more and more towards Canada now, just because of the fact I saw a very U.S. looking, there's way too many trucks here for this to be like mainland France.
So now, I'm not gonna say that I've never gotten it wrong,
okay?
Because I've definitely gotten it wrong,
okay,
in the past, but. In general, I think it essentially comes down to if it looks like America, but you see France, and this is going to get me in trouble.
Okay.
If it looks like America, but you see French, you're in Quebec.
Right.
And it's not, again, I don't think that's going to make me a popular person for saying that, but
I almost
we were both close.
I almost missed the timer. I didn't want to go further northern than that. Like that felt like a mistake, but. I saw zero city signs. I saw only just French everywhere.
Yeah, I mean, you got 46. That's nothing to apologize for.
I'm not apologizing. I'm just saying it's complete luck.
But with your luck, shouldn't you have gotten like a 15?
The last time I was not sandbagging.
I thought like in general you had bad luck in this game.
I have bad luck overall in video games. And I don't, you know, let the debate rage whether or not you guess there's an actual video game or not.
Oh, I think it's a video game.
I mean, I do too.
Dude, I had a great idea. And I believe it or not, I think I actually do have the skills to make it.
Okay.
An exact ripoff of that doesn't mean I'm gonna make it.
Oh.
So if you're listening to this and you're like, I want to make that, and I could do it in 48 hours, please do. You have my blessing. It's an exact ripoff of GeoGuessr.
Okay.
Except they show you a picture of like a food item from that country, and then you click on what country it is. So you're like, obviously they can't show you, you know, like a meatball, and then you'll be like, oh, that's from this district in Stockholm, like that's a little too fine grain. But they can show you, like, you know, for Canada, we have this street food called like a beaver tail. It's a like fried dough with powdered sugar on it, like a funnel cake sort of thing. They could pop that up, and you'd be like, "What is this garbage? I have no idea." That seems like something they probably serve in like Belarus. 10 points.
I mean, it does sound like a funnel cake. Funnel cakes are great, by the way.
It's not like a funnel cake is. It's almost like dough noodles, right? Like,
yes, pretty much.
Yeah, beaver tail is more like a pancake. It's almost like a sweet pita or something. But
it actually sounds pretty good.
It's literally like it's the best. The human brain is designed to enjoy the taste of a beaver tail. It's just fried dough with sugar on it.
Thank you for not saying. It's just predisposed to enjoy the taste of a nice fresh beaver.
I know what you're saying.
Yeah. Yeah. Copyright 2017 Google. Oh, yeah? Which part, Google? The 288 pixel resolution on the left or the...
No, just actually the land here.
Ah, okay.
Google and Disney are in a war with one another to see who can own planet Earth first.
Gotcha.
Jesus.
The only thing I've seen so far is a real estate sign and a junction that not use numbers.
Yeah.
Which I think that we've come across before somewhere around this part of the country.
I think I think it's just an American thing. Like, I've definitely seen it in the American South, but I think it might just be like an all over sort of American thing.
I don't ever recall seeing a junction that said junction like Z, for example, because normally they're represented by numbers, but
yeah,
I'm sure they do exist somewhere in Texas. Texas, if you didn't know, Texas is a pretty big place. You may not be familiar with large areas of land.
It's not that large, though, is the thing. Like, it's pretty big compared to the other states. I'll give you that.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's way bigger than Canada.
I mean, all I'm saying is that there are a few Canadian provinces that can swallow it up easily.
Like, I'm being facetious, chat, calm down.
There's Texas there. It's like a little baby. Oh my god, Texas is so big. Look, it's so much bigger than Oklahoma.
Everything.
Oh wait, here's British Columbia. Eat it in one bite. Here's Ontario. It's an atom compared to the size of Ontario.
Everything's bigger in Texas more than
that. Except the state itself.
I'm picking the tri-corners of Minnesota.
Fuck.
Okay. I'll take it.
I mean, you got me.
You picked up a perfect score. Quad deuces. That's a good hand.
Is Texas the largest American state?
No.
California?
No. It's down to California versus Alaska.
Okay.
If you're talking
that was my next guess.
If you're talking about the lower 48, California's got Texas beat. As far as sheer, like, area is concerned.
Like land, surface area?
Yeah, yeah. Uh-oh. You guess it's frozen. I can't go forward. I'm doing the whole 2-centimeter crawl here. Country.
Oh, Lord.
Country Winkle. Weckery? Weckery? I don't know what that means.
It's one of these.
Yep.
One of these countries.
I was told that Finland is not part of Scandinavia.
And that's it's something that's come up before, but like,
I thought that just whole region was considered.
No, that's us being ignorant and North American. But in our defense, it's very confusing because there are countries that in that area, like Norway, Denmark, Sweden, Finland, I think Estonia, maybe Latvia, I don't know, maybe Lithuania, again, I don't know. But some of them are Scandinavian, some of them are Nordic, and some of them are Baltic.
Right.
But not all of them are each, which makes sense, because otherwise why would you have like 10 different names? But I'm just saying,
it's like, what, just name your countries different from each other.
Exactly. It's like, I get that there are reasons for it, but I also think that if you live in the region, you have to understand that a lot of people are going to, there's going to be a learning curve. Because people go, well, the Baltic, and I keep saying Balk for some reason, but the Baltic states are on the Baltic Sea, so it's easy to remember. No, it's not, because the average North American can't point to the Baltic Sea on a map.
They just need to play more GeoGuessr.
You hear about these things when you grow up. You know, you go, oh, the trouble in the Baltic, trouble on the Black Sea. But unless you actually, like, look at the map, you never see them. You just go, oh, that's somewhere over here. So, you know, we're trying. You know, we play GeoGuessr with people, and I'm not naming names. We play GeoGuessr with Americans.
Yes.
That they go, oh, this is Minnesota. And then they can't find Minnesota on the map. That's what, it, like, I'm not going to say drives me insane, but I'm like, how does that happen? You don't even know how to find something within your own country.
I guess it, you could go along the same logic and say, well, how do you not know your state's flag if you live in there? I know what the Texas state flag is, no, California, like, Alaska, that's about
where
it.
Where it is on the map, though?
Yeah, but where it is on the map, I mean, yeah.
You should know. I'm not insulting all Americans. Sinvicta has never had this happen. And there are times, I don't live in America, but there are times where I've been like, I don't exactly know, like, which one of these is Alabama, which one of these is Kentucky, which one of blah, blah, blah. So I feel you on that, but
I'm not even from America. I know.
Yeah, exactly.
Dude, I am so confused right now.
Do you know the country?
I thought I did. But I might just bomb this one, because I'm not... I've seen a couple of things that would have told me... No, we can't be... We're not in this country. No, there's no way. Yeah, I'm striking out here.
You know, take it down.
I was thinking about the road that we saw. That's going to be wrong. Oh, my God. Yeah. I got 48 points on that.
Oh!
I did not see...
You put us in Australia?
No, I just put us in a random spot near Denmark. Because I only saw
near
that...
Denmark!
I only saw the country thing, and I was like, okay, that sounds vaguely familiar. But I saw... The only thing that would have clued me in that it was South Africa was I saw the R-34, and I was like, hang on. I was like, it can't be... I know that we're not anywhere near Scandinavia, but anyway... A rare miss on a South African guess. I didn't believe what I saw.
I'm not going to say it doesn't happen.
Well, it just happened.
There you go. Exactly.
All right.
But I also only saw the R-34, but I was definitely thinking Australia before that.
Really?
Yeah. Look, buddy.
I'm
you picked Denmark when it was South Africa.
I don't. If I would have known it was South Africa, don't you think I would have put it in South Africa?
Yeah, but South Africa and Australia are like cousins. They look the same on the map or on the picture until you know what's going on. Denmark is like, you know, it's Nordic or Baltic or Scandinavian. It's part of the Kalmar Union. I can't remember. It's one of the.
I told you it was random.
All right. Well, I think I know the country.
Yes, you should know the country based on the first sign that you saw.
I get very mad, though, because I know the country, but, like, I saw a bunch of cities on the sign, but I don't recognize any of the city names. And then I did a perusal of the map and got none of them. So I said to myself, how big could these cities be? And the answer is apparently.
I mean, if they've got an arc for them, not an arch, but an arc.
Yeah,
for them. They got to be pretty big, right?
Yeah, they only build arches for like
major cities.
Cities that deserve them.
Yeah, like St. Louis.
Did you know, I saw this on Twitter. I don't know. It could be quote-unquote fake news. But before there was environmental regulation in East St. Louis, one time the water was so polluted that a child started a fire by riding their bike in a dry riverbed.
What?
That's, I'm just saying, I saw it on Twitter. It had many, many dozens of thousands of retweets.
Okay, so
it must be true.
So explain the scenario then, because you said that a place was so polluted that some kid was riding in a dry riverbed that caused a fire.
Yeah, based on the water has like some kind of chemical waste or and something flammable that's a byproduct of industry. Now, when the water dried out in the riverbed, it left a residue of that flammable chemical, and then a child riding their bike through the dry riverbed caused a fire in the city. I don't know if it ravaged the city. I'm just saying. Here, I mean, I'm going to put us there. So,
I found
East
the
St. Louis pollution riverbed bike tire fire child.
I thought you were saying you're putting your guess near somewhere East St. Louis. I'm like, come on, Northern Lion. Please don't.
This is not East St. Louis.
No, I found a road that has the three cities we've seen, so.
Really?
It's all about just measuring the distance. And I'm terrible at doing that on a map without a scale.
They really should put a legend on the map.
Yeah, it would help a lot, but that also might, like, be considered.
I don't think it makes it too easy. Like, is that the goal of GeoGuessers, to see who's the best at judging distances without having a...
Maybe.
Without having the ability to do so? I don't think so.
Maybe I should be in this county line. If this is on the border of the county.
Could have been closer, could have been further.
Gotcha, by 835. Or no, 44.
I believe that. I believe that. What's your score going into the final round?
I have 13-509.
Okay, I got 15-052.
I think you got this one.
It gives me the edge. Up. I will say it's kind of it's a slight on me that you got 48 points on one of the guesses and I got like 4,300, and yet you're only down by 1,500 now at the end. So.
I've been making some decent gains here, but
you must have me beat on the other four. Like, that's
no, you, I think I'm pretty sure that you beat me on the Canada guess.
No, you beat me on the Canada guess, I think.
Did I? No, I think you did. I think you said you got me by 400 or something.
No, I think you got me by 400.
Let's just both admit that we're both awful and terrible.
Well, I mean, my South Africa guess was pretty good, but
I know the state that we're in.
Really?
Yep. If there's a sign that shows exactly what state you're in. Now, this has got to be a county road. This is not a highway.
You ever live rural enough that the streets where you live didn't have a name except for what the government had given them, essentially?
No, but I've taken on-sites to places like that when I did the on-site IT stuff. That was a nightmare. Going into the county country roads of Texas where there are road signs, but they kind of just are very small. I mean, very, very tiny. And also the fact that, like, Texas has cities that are named after other cities.
And I get
cities.
It's large.
I didn't say anything about the size.
It's so big.
This one Rob would be like, hey-o, yeah it is. No, no, he's probably still asleep. Actually, he's probably not asleep.
Yeah, I don't know, he might be. Used to have a friend. He didn't live on this corner, but he lived near this corner. I'm not giving away his personal information. But if you wanted to get to his house, like the third to last step was go to the corner of County Road 6 and Highway 2. And when you do, that was quite a nightmare pre-Google Maps era,
right.
Let me tell you. You'd just be like, okay, here's Highway 2. I guess I'll just follow this. And it's not like it goes County Road 1, County Road 2, County Road 3. County Road 6 might be like, you know, 100 kilometers north of County Road 4.
In your lifetime, how many times do you think you've actually used a key map?
What is a key map?
It's a map that breaks down locations based on a grid. So like,
oh, like an A to H, 1 to 8 sort of thing?
Yes.
Probably like 50 to 75 times is my guess.
Okay.
That's
way more than I've ever used it. I was going to say probably like 30 times for me.
I used to work, actually, you know what? I've probably used it like 200 times. So I used to work as a summer student for this charity that picked up donations from
people
to
okay.
sell them in a store. And my job was essentially, I would collate the data from the address data from the telephone operators.
Right.
And then make a list of it. And then I would use a key map to figure out the route that the driver should take. So I'd be like, okay, all these are in like A7. All these are in like B6. So you'll go like here. You get the idea.
I realize that some people may think that sounds boring. To me, that actually sounds pretty interesting to have to... You're essentially the navigator for... You're like air traffic controller, except you're on the ground.
Sort of. Like, as far as summer jobs go, it was pretty okay.
We were basically equidistant. You got me by, I think, by like 70 or 64 point.
Well, thank you, South Africa, for essentially bailing me out.
Where the heck was the 931 or 913? Ah, there it is. Yeah, well, Northern Lion gets one back. We're back down. I believe that I only have a one game lead. Oh man, that South African guess. I should have practiced what I preached when I talked to Rob. It was either Rob or Krendor, telling him about the yellow text on the green sign combo. That's almost a clear South African there, bud.
Yeah. I mean, it's or Australia, but anyway.
Or Australia.
Thanks for watching. I hope you guys have enjoyed the episode. If you did, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. Of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. For now, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.
See you later.